Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will learn about the ring oscillator. So this ring oscillator is a digital circuit which is designed using the inverters or the NOT gates. And since it is an oscillator circuit, so it will generate a square wave of the specific frequency. So as you know, in the inverter or in the NOT gate, if we apply a logic 0 as an input, then at the output we will get the logic 1. And likewise, when we apply the logic 1 as an input, then at the output, we will get the logic 0. So when multiple such inverters are cascaded, and when the output is feedback to the input side, then this circuit will act as a ring oscillator. So in this configuration, if the number of inverters in the chain are even, then this circuit won't work. So for this circuit to work as an oscillator, the number of inverters in the chain should be odd. So let us understand this point with the help of the example. So let's say the two inverters are connected in the chain and the output of the second inverter is connected back to the input side. Now initially, let's say the input of the first inverter is equal to 0. That means if we see the output of the first inverter, then it will be equal to 1. And this 1 will act as an input for the second inverter. That means if we see the output of the second inverter, then that is equal to 0. And the same 0 will be feedback to the input side. That means once again, after the second iteration also, the output of the circuit will remain 0. And same will be the case when the input is equal to logic 1. That means whenever the initial input is equal to logic 1, then at the output, we will also get the logic 1. So as you can see, when we have an even number of inverters in the chain, then the output of the ring oscillator will get less to the specific state. That means if the initial input is 0, then it will remain 0. And if the initial input is 1, then the output of the ring oscillator will get less to the logic 1. And in this way, it won't work as an oscillator. So for this circuit to work as an oscillator, the number of inverters in the chain should be equal to odd. So instead of 2, if we have a 3 inverters in the chain, then this circuit will work as the oscillator. For example, initially, if the input to the first inverter is equal to logic 0, then its output will be equal to logic 1. So now, this 1 will be the input for the second inverter. And if we see the output of the second inverter, then that is equal to logic 0. That means now, the output of the third inverter is equal to logic 1. And the same 1 will be fed back to the input side. So initially, the input to the first inverter was the logic 0. But now, after the first iteration, it will become logic 1. So now, if we see the output of this ring oscillator, then that is equal to logic 0. So in this way, with the each iteration, the output of this ring oscillator will toggle between the logic 1 and the logic 0. And in this way, we can get the square pulse at the output. So here, the output of each inverter will not change instantaneously. And as you know, it will change only after the finite propagation delay. So typically, since all the inverters in the chain are fabricated on the same wafer, so typically, they have the same propagation delay. So let's say, the propagation delay of the each inverter is equal to TP. So here, the output of the ring oscillator will change after the delay of the 3TP. That means initially, if the input to the ring oscillator is equal to logic 1, then it will become 0. After the delay of the 3TP. That means here, this duration is equal to 3TP. So now, this 0 will be fed back to the input side, and once again, the output will become 1 after the propagation delay of the 3TP. That means if we see the total time period of the output signal, then that is equal to 6TP. Or we can say that the frequency of oscillation is equal to 1 divided by 6TP. Or that is equal to 1 divided by 2 times 3TP. So in general, if we have a n number of inverters in the ring oscillator, and if the propagation delay of the each inverter is equal to TP, then we can say that the frequency of oscillation is equal to 1 divided by this 2 times nTP. So with the given propagation delay of the inverter, by changing the number of inverters in the chain, it is possible to change the oscillation frequency. For example, if the propagation delay of the each inverter is equal to 1 nanosecond, and if the required oscillation frequency is equal to 100 MHz, then as you can see from this equation, we need to connect total 5 inverters in the given ring oscillator. So in this way, by changing the value of n or by changing the number of inverters in the ring oscillator, it is possible to change the frequency of the oscillation. So now, let us see the applications of this ring oscillator. So internally, if you see the inverter, then this is how it will look like. So basically, it consists of the PMOS and the NMOS transistors. So in this inverter, this propagation delay is the function of the supply voltage. That means as the supply voltage increases, then the propagation delay will reduce. And vice versa, as the supply voltage reduces, then the propagation delay of the inverter will increase. And as you know, the frequency of the ring oscillator depends on the propagation delay of this inverter. So we can say that for the n stage ring oscillator, the frequency of the oscillation is also a function of the biasing voltage. That means as the supply voltage increases, then the propagation delay will reduce and hence the oscillation frequency will increase. And vice versa, when the supply voltage reduces, then the oscillation frequency of the ring oscillator will reduce. And that is why this ring oscillator is often used as the voltage controlled oscillator. That means by changing the biasing voltage of the ring oscillator, it is possible to change the frequency of the oscillation. Now another application of the ring oscillator is for generating the random numbers. Or in other words, it can be used as a random number generator. So like I said, the propagation delay of the inverter is a function of the biasing voltage. But apart from that, it is also a function of the temperature. That means with the change in the temperature also, the propagation delay of the inverter will change. That means due to the localized variation in the temperature and due to the voltage fluctuations, the propagation delay of each inverter will change. And because of that, the frequency of the ring oscillator will also change. And that will lead to the jitter in the oscillation frequency. So this jitter is basically a fluctuation in the exact timing of the transitions in the ring oscillator output. So we can use this jitter or the uncertainty in the transition to generate the random number. So for that, we can sample the output of the oscillator at the specific time. So the output state of the oscillator at this sampling point will generate the random bits of 1s and 0s. And in this way, it is possible to generate the random number. So typically if you see, then the jitter in the ring oscillator is not truly random. So if we sample the signal at the fixed interval, then we might find some pattern in the random numbers. So typically, to improve the randomness, more than one ring oscillators are used, and these oscillators will also have the different characteristics. Like the each oscillator might have the different number of stages and might have the different transistor sizes. So in this way, due to the different characteristics, the randomness in the each oscillator will be different. So the output of the each ring oscillator is sampled at the different times and the each sampled output is finally XORed. So in this way, it is possible to improve the randomness in the generated pattern. So apart from that, it can also be used for measuring the voltage or temperature in the ICs. So we know that in the ring oscillator, as the temperature increases, then the propagation delay of the inverter will increase. And because of that, the oscillation frequency will reduce. So by measuring the oscillation frequency, we can measure the temperature of the chip. That means when the chip is manufactured, at that time, at the fixed temperature, the frequency of the ring oscillator has been measured. Now during the usage, as the temperature increases, then this output frequency of the ring oscillator is compared with the calibrated value. And from that, it is easy to estimate the temperature of the chip. So while measuring the temperature, we need to ensure that the voltage of the chip is constant. Because as you know, the frequency of the ring oscillator is function of both temperature and the voltage. That means if both the parameter changes at the same time, then it is not possible to measure one of the parameter. Likewise, if the temperature of the chip is kept constant, then it is possible to measure the change in the biasing voltage with the same principle. So measuring the temperature of the IC using the ring oscillator is a low-cost solution which can be implemented within the IC itself. So this is one of the applications of the ring oscillator. Apart from that, these ring oscillators are also used for benchmarking the new hardware technology. So basically, using a new hardware technology, a ring oscillator of the specific stages has been designed. And the oscillation frequency of the ring oscillator has been measured. So we know that the frequency of the oscillation can be given by this expression. So if we know the frequency, as well as the number of stages in the ring oscillator, then it is easy to estimate the propagation delay of the each inverter. And in this way, it is possible to measure the propagation delay of the inverters, which is designed using the new hardware technology. And from this, we can get the insight of the speed and performance of the new hardware technology. That means these ring oscillators are typically used in the benchmarking the new hardware technology. So apart from that, they are also used in the wafer testing. So during the wafer testing, these ring oscillators are embedded in the wafers as a test structure. And by doing so, it is possible to monitor the various aspects of the manufacturing process. So if there is a deviation in the manufacturing process, then it can affect the transistor behavior. And because of that, it will affect the propagation delay of the inverter. So basically, by measuring the oscillation frequency of the ring oscillator, we can find the deviation in the manufacturing process. That means across the wafer, by analyzing such ring oscillator frequencies, it is possible to identify the variations in the manufacturing process. So in short, these are the few applications of the ring oscillator. So I hope in this video, you understood what is ring oscillator, how it can be designed, and what are the applications of the ring oscillators. So if you have any question or suggestion, then do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe the channel for more such videos.